Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you, my students? My name is Shaima Bah. I am Quran and Arabic teacher. Inshallah, I will step by step with you to learn Quran, Arabic, and Tajweed rules. Today, inshallah, we will study together a new Tajweed lesson. The lesson today is about the articulation points, makharij al-huruf. In the last class, we started learning the articulation points. The Arabic letters, the sounds of Arabic letters come from five articulation points. Al-jawf, oral cavity, al-halq, the throat, al-lisan, the tongue, and al-khayshum, the nose, and al-shafatan, the lips. Today, inshallah, we will study together. The first articulation point is al-jawf. Please listen to the next pictures and tell me what do you notice. Click on the picture and say what you hear. Picture number one, huh? Click. Ah. Picture number two, click. Ooh, picture number three, click. E, what do you notice? Teacher, I notice long sound. Yes, please tell me, what is the meaning of long sound? Long sound means the word has met with alif, or with waw, or with ya. Yes, very good. Can you tell me how many mad letters? Yes, mad letters are three letters, alif, waw, and ya. Yes, these three letters, we can find a word in Quran that contains the three letters of mad. Do you know which ayah? Yes. Yes, teacher. The word is Nuhiha. We can find it in Surah Hud, ayah number 49. Yes, very good. Please listen to the ayat. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. تلك من أنباء الغيب نوحيها إليك ما كنت تعلمها أنت ولا قومك من قبل هذا فاصبر إن العاقبة للمتقين. Yes, the word نوحيها contains the three mad letters, the alif mad, the waw mad, and the ya mad. These three letters are articulated from oral cavity. Today, inshallah, we will study together makhraj al-jawf, the oral cavity. We will study in this lesson 6 points about the oral cavity. The first point is the definition of the cavity. The second point is the sound. So the letters come from the cavity. The third point is the mad letters. The fourth point is the shape of the mouth when pronouncing the three letters of mad. The fifth point is correct pronunciation. The last point is test your knowledge about the oral cavity. Let's start with the first point, definition. The cavity means the empty space in the throat and mouth. In Arabic, تجويف الفم والحلق. The mad letters, alif mad, waw mad, and ya mad. The second point today is mad letters. The mad letters. Mad letters three, alif mad, waw mad, and ya mad. Alif Mad means Alif Sakina preceded by Fatha. Please repeat after me. Qala. Qadirun. Wassafati. Waw Mad means Waw Sakin preceded by Dhamma. Please repeat after me. Yaqulu. شاكور غفور. يا مد means يا ساكن preceded by كسرة. Please repeat after me the examples. قيل كريم المتين Let's go to the last The third point today is what? The third point is the shape of the mouth when pronouncing the three letters of mat. When you pronounce alif mat like qala, what is the shape of the mouth? Please look at the picture and repeat after me. Qala. Where is the tongue? What is the shape of the tongue? The tongue is at the bottom of the mouth. Qa. Okay. Waw mad. Please repeat after me. Yaqulu. What is the shape of the mouth? Yes. The deepest part of the tongue is raised with rounded lips. Example. Yaqulu. Deepest part is raised. Deepest part of the tongue is raised. Lips is rounding. Ooh, ooh. Yamad like qila. The middle part of the tongue is raised. Qi. Okay. Can you notice the difference between pronouncing alif mad, waw mad, and yamad? Okay. Conclusion. What do you learn it from the three points? The cavity is the empty space in the throat and mouth. The shape of the mouth and tongue differs when pronouncing them. The cavity is the articulation point for the three mad letters. The fourth point, correct pronunciation. Number one, you shouldn't open your mouth too much when pronouncing alif mat. Example, please look at this word, anhar. The right pronouncing is anhar. The wrong pronouncing is anhar. No. Don't open your mouth too much when pronouncing alif mat. Not ha, no. Alif mad is modified from oral cavity and it's light or heavy according the letter before. In this example, there is a light letter before alif mad, so it's light too. Example, an-nar. The right pronouncing is an-nar. Noon is light or heavy? Yes, it's light. It's na, not na. So it's an-nar. The wrong pronouncing is no, not annor. You shouldn't add kasra to alif fat. It wouldn't sound like letter ya. Okay? Example. Please look at this example. It's Isa. The right pronouncing is Isa. The wrong pronouncing is Isa. No, don't add kasra to alif fat. You should round your lips completely to produce a clear sound for waw mat. You shouldn't add fatha to it. Example, shakuron. The right pronouncing is shakuron, kuron, complete dhamma. The wrong pronouncing is shakuron, not ko. Either tafkhim or tarkik is applied to alif mad based on the letter before it. An-nahar. The right pronouncing is النهار. Ha, it's light, not heavy, because ha is light. The wrong pronouncing is النهار. No, not ha, it's ha. Tafkhim should be applied to alif mad during the whole mad duration. You shouldn't add tarkik during mad or before pronouncing the letter. Example, الضالين. The right pronouncing is الضالين. The wrong pronouncing is الدالين. No. Don't apply to alif mad during the whole mad duration. You shouldn't add tarkik during mad or before pronouncing the letter. You should pronounce ya mad clearly and not add fatha sound to it. Example, ad-deen. The right pronouncing is ad-deen, but the wrong pronouncing is ad-deen. Let's practice pronouncing alif mad, waw mad, and ya mad. Let's start with alif mad. Please repeat after me. النار. الناس. قادر. والصافات. غافر. Let's practice waw mad. Please repeat after me. Wadudin. Mamnunin. Ghafurin or ghafuron. Shakurun. Manshurin. Yamad. Please repeat after me to practice Yamad. Azimin. Karimin. Almatinu. Qadirun. Banina. Let's go to the last part. Today is test your knowledge about the oral cavity. I will ask you three questions. The first question, choose the correct answer. The second question, drop and drag letter mad with its correct shape. The last question, listen and choose the correct pronunciation. Let's start with the first question, is choose the correct answer. When the letter of mad are pronounced, which one is right? Number one, nothing obstructs the air. Number two, the mouth obstructed the air. Number three, the throat obstructed the air. Which one is right? Yes, nothing obstructed the air. The three letters of mad are found in which word? Nuhiha or Nu'tihi or Mursaha? Yes, Nuhiha. Very good. Question number two, drop and drag letter mad with its correct shape. Please look at the first picture. Pronouncing what? Waw mad or alif mad or ya mad? Which one? In this picture, the tongue, what is the shape of the tongue? At the bottom, is it right? The bottom of the mouth. Which one? Yes, alif mad. Number two, the middle part of the tongue is raised. Which one? Waw mad or ya mad? Yes, ya mad. Number three, the deepest part of the tongue is raised and rounded your lips. Yes, wow, Matt. Very good. Let's go to the last question. Listen and choose the correct pronunciation. Please look at the word. Listen to the first pronunciation. One, ad-dallin. Number two, ad-dallin. Which one is right? Yes, number one is right. Please look at the word. Huh, which one is right? Ad-din. Number two, ad-din. Huh, which one? Yes, number two, ad-din, not ad-din. Look at the word. Number one, an-nahar. Number two, an-nahar. An-nahar or an-nahar. One or two? Yes, number two, an-nahar. Please look at the word. Number one, an-nahar. Number two, an-nahar. Which one? Yes, number one, an-nahar. Look at the word. Number one, al-mustaghfirin. Number two, al-mustaghfirin. Which one? Yes, number one, al-mustaghfirin. You finished the test. Congratulations. Very good. Excellent. I am proud of you. Now it's time to leave you. That's great to see you today. Please, if this video is useful for you, don't forget to make, like, share, and subscribe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.